Today we are going to see energy in terms of definition, forms and determination of energy value of food and physiological fuel value of foods. The human body utilizes the potential energy present in foods for maintaining life and doing work. The energy yielding food factors are carbohydrates, fats and protein. Within the body, these nutrients are oxidized in cells with the help of catalysts such as enzymes, coenzymes and hormones. This process is one of the continuous process of utilizing oxygen and producing carbon dioxide and water with the release of heat. The heat in terms of energy depends on the quantity of carbohydrate, fat and protein present in it. This can be determined by oxidizing the known weight of food in an instrument called bomb calorimeter and measuring the heat produced and used for energy content determination. After completing this module, the students are able to find out energy content of food, understand the difference between actual energy content of food and physiological fuel value of foods, and also measure the energy value of nutrients present in food and in human body. All of you know what is energy. Yes. Energy is the ability to do work or to produce a change in a matter. When used in nutrition, energy deals mostly with chemical energy locked in foodstuff by the reason of chemical bonding present in it. So, energy in nutrition is focused on chemical energy and kinetic energy of motion. You must have heard about different forms of energy available to us. In human body, about 80% of energy obtained from food is converted into heat and the rest is converted into mechanical, osmotic, chemical and electronic energy to keep the body functioning. Not only energy from foods, but also the potential energy, that is the energy stored in the body, is continuously available from small amount of glycogen in muscles and liver, the fat deposits and cellular mass itself. This potential energy is transformed to other forms to accomplish the work of the body. For example, mechanical energy for muscular contraction, osmotic energy to maintain the transport of fluid and nutrients, electrical energy for transmission of nerves impulse, chemical energy as in the synthesis of new compounds, and thermal energy for heat regulation. Next, we will see the units of energy. The unit of energy commonly used in human nutrition is kilocalorie, which is equivalent to 1000 calories. Although the kilocalorie is a proper term, calorie is commonly used interchangeable term. Now, you can understand that the calorie and kilocalories are the standard units of heat measurement. This kilocalorie is defined as the heat energy required to raise the temperature of 1 kilogram of water through 1 degree centigrade, that is 14.5 to 15.5 degree centigrade. Recently, the International Union of Sciences and International Union of Nutritional Science have adopted joules as a unit of energy in place of kilocalories. It is important to know the relationship between these two measurements of energy. The conversion from calories to joule is made by multiplying by 4.184, that is 4.2, for many purposes sent in it. Determination of energy value of food. The energy in food is provided entirely by its carbohydrate, fats and protein components. The energy value of food, which is called as fuel value of food, and is usually and readily determined by the means of an instrument known as bomb calorimeter. This is the method of a direct calorimeter or indirect measurement of heat. Bomb calorimeter. Let us understand the principles assembling of the bomb calorimeter and the actual method of doing the experiment. The principle behind the working of bomb calorimeter is based on the fact that a known weight of a dried food sample is completely burned within the container and this produces heat. This heat is absorbed by a definite amount of water surrounding the container. By measuring the change in the temperature of this known amount of water in the container, it is possible to calculate the number of kilocalories of heat produced by burning the sample. Let us study the parts of this instrument. The oxygen bomb calorimeter consists of three essential parts, namely, number one, bomb or vessel, in which the combustible material is burned. The calorimeter bucket or water container holding a measured quantity of water in which bomb is immersed. The jacket for protecting the calorimeter bucket from the effect of variation in room temperature. Let us have a look on the bomb calorimeter in detail. The sample cup for weighing food sample. Bomb filled with pure oxygen enclosing food sample. The bucket holding water of known amount in which the bomb is immersed. The outer double-walled insulating jacket, water stirrer, thermometer, ignition wire to send current through fuse. Let us have a look on the bomb calorimeter in detail. The bomb is made up of strong, thick-walled, heavy steel with mechanically sealed cover which can be removed by screwing for inserting the sample and for cleaning. There are two electrodes attached to underside of the double-walled head of the cover. The platinum fuse wire helps in ignition of the sample. Both these electrodes serve as a binding post for the fuse wire, which is strung between electrode and the fuse wire is bent down to have contact with the sample and to instrument. The stirrer attached to the lid, the cup for holding food sample to be analyzed. The thermometer is specially designed and supplied along with the instrument. The stirrer attached to the lid of the jacket for maintaining the uniform temperature of water in the bucket. Next aspect is assembling of the bomb. The food to be analyzed is taken in a dried form. 1 gram of the sample is weighed and taken in this cup. The cup is placed on the basement of the electrode head. 11 cm of fuse wire is cut and connected to the electrode through a hole present in it, in such a way that the fuse wire is in contact with the food sample. The cover is kept in the place of bomb head and closed tightly. Now, the bomb is fixed firmly in the frame on the table. The insert knob for oxygen on the bomb head is open and about 15 to 20 atmosphere of oxygen is filled. Then the inlet is closed tightly. This apparatus works at a normal pressure of 15 to 100 atmosphere but can withstand a pressure up to 200 atmosphere. The air which trapped into the bomb when it is enclosed containing nitrogen and in the bomb, some of the nitrogen oxidized and combined with water vapor to form nitric acid. Like this, if the sample is being burned contains sulfur, it is converted to sulfuric acid. These several acids combine to form corrosive mixture with which the residue oxygen at high temperature generates an atmosphere which will combustible the food sample. 2 liter of distilled water cooled to 2 degrees Celsius below the room temperature is taken in calorimeter bucket. The bomb is filled with oxygen, is now placed in the bucket immersed in water. This is the connector wire from the calorimeter circuit which when attached to bomb completes the circuit. The connector wire is now connected to the bomb and the calorimeter circuit is closed. The thermometer is inserted and the stirring mechanism is started. This stirrer running at constant speed circulates water uniformly. This is the required for uniform absorption of heat liberated by the bomb and to maintain temperature equilibrium throughout the bucket. The stirrer is allowed to run for 2 minutes before taking the temperature. The temperature readings are recorded at 1 minute interval for an initial period of 5 minutes. If over period of 5 minutes, the temperature is constant, exactly at 5th minute, the circuit is closed mandatorily to fire the charge. This facilitates the ignition of the fuse wire. The heat dissipates into the water and temperature starts rising slowly. The thermometer readings are exactly the minute after ignition are recorded. The maximum constant temperature shown by the thermometer is recorded finally. Now, the calorimeter lid is opened and the bomb is removed. The bomb is once again fixed on the table and the residual oxygen in the bomb is released by loosening the gas release valve present on the lid of the bomb. The remaining length of the fuse wire is removed from the electrode, straightened, and length of all pieces combines to make the fuse wire correction. By recording the change in the temperature of water, calculate the energy value of food. The calculation used for it is initial temperature of water 85.7 degree Fahrenheit, final temperature of water 88.25 Fahrenheit. The rise in temperature is 2.55 degree Fahrenheit. The initial length of the wire is 11 cm. The remaining length of wire is 7 cm. Energy equivalent for calorimeter in calories per degree is 1348 kilocalorie. Therefore, the calories for 2.55 degree Fahrenheit in temperature is 1348 into 2.55, that is 3437 kilocalorie. The energy equivalent for the wire in calories per degree is 2.3 kilocalorie. Calorie for 4 centimeter wire which got burned is 9.2 kilocalorie. The fuse wire correction is 3437 minus 9.2, that is 3428.8 kilocalorie. That is 1 gram of sample yielded 3427.8 kilocalorie of energy. Therefore, 100 gram of sample will yield 342.78 kilocalorie of energy. By this time, you will be able to know the forms, units of energy and determination of energy value of food. Now, discuss about the physiological fuel value of force and determination of energy exchange in the body. To understand the physiological fuel value of force, we have to know about the heat of combustion of food and coefficient of digestibility. What is heat? of combustion. The energy value of a sample of food is determined in bomb calorimeter is known as heat of combustion, that is maximum amount of energy that the sample is capable of yielding when it is completely burned or oxidized. The amount of heat produced per gram of purified sample of protein, fat and carbohydrate burned in the bomb calorimeter is 1 gram of protein produced 5.65 kilocalorie, 1 gram of fat produced 9.45 kilocalorie and 1 gram of carbohydrate produced 4.1 kilocalorie. Now we shall note the coefficient of digestibility. Once the food is taken in the body, it is not completely digested or absorbed. The extent to which the ingested nutrient is available to the cell is called digestibility. To calculate the potential energy from carbohydrate, protein and fat, the coefficient of digestibility of the nutrient that is ultimately available. For carbohydrate, fat and protein, the coefficient of digestibility are 98, 95 and 92 respectively, that showing that they are 98%, 95% and 92% digested and absorbed. The physiological fuel value is the amount of potential energy available to the body or the maximum amount of heat that the body can receive from oxidizing the energy components in foods like carbohydrate, fat and protein. This is important in human nutrition. This is derived from the value of heat of combustion and the digestibility of nutrients. The factors 4, 9 and 4 represents the amount of energy available to the body per gram of carbohydrate, fat and protein respectively. It is important to understand the method by which the factors have arrived at in detail. In bomb calorimeter, carbohydrates and fats are completely oxidized to produce carbon dioxide and water with the release of heat. Protein is oxidized to carbon dioxide and water and nitrogen. All these result in release of heat. In this small amount of heat loss occur in digestion. It is estimated as 2% for carbohydrate, 5% for fat and 8% for protein. However, in protein metabolism, due to incomplete oxidation, some more loss of energy occurs. That is, the end products of protein metabolism such as urine and nitrogenous products which are combustible and lost in urine accounts for some more loss of energy. This has been estimated to be 1.25 kilocalorie per gram of protein. Another important error in the use of bomb calorimeter for determining energy value of food, especially the plant food, is that fiber present in food is burned and produce heat, whereas it is not utilized in human being. But in the utilization of carbohydrate, fats and protein in the body, certain percentage is lost in digestion and nitrogen in protein is excreted in the form of urea and also contain some energy. By applying these corrections, the physiological fuel factor, which are also termed as physiological energy value of food, have been derived. Now we will look at this table, the calculation of physiological fuel of nutrients in terms of kilocalorie. Calculation of calorific value of foodstuff from proximate composition. Understanding physiological fuel value of food, the calorific value of foods can be calculated from the content of carbohydrate, fat and protein. Benetic oxycalorimeter is another apparatus used for determination of energy value of food, which is devised by Benedict and his co-workers. This instrument measures the volume of oxygen required to burn a known weight of food. This apparatus consists of combustion chamber in which known amount of sample is burned, soda lime container for absorption of carbon dioxide, spirometer for measuring oxygen use, and motor blower unit for circulating gas mixture. Using this instrument, the amount of oxygen consumed in burning 1 gram of pure carbohydrate, fat and protein can be determined. Now we shall see the relationship between oxygen requirement and calorific value of foods. It is important to know that heat produced when 1 liter of oxygen is used for oxidation of carbohydrate, fat and protein. This can be calculated from the data obtained by bomb calorimeter and oxycalorimeter. 1 gram of carbohydrate requires about 0.8 liter of oxygen for complete oxidation and produce 4.1 kilocalorie of energy, whereas fat produce 9.5 kilocalorie of energy, and 1 gram of protein requires about 1.2 liter of oxygen for complete oxidation and produce 5.5 kilocalorie of energy. Let us understand the energy exchange in the body and methods of measuring it. The amount of heat produced by the body can be measured by direct and indirect methods. By this method, the relationship between energy output and oxygen consumed has been determined. Reliable data regarding the energy output, oxygen consumed in human being could be obtained using this Edgewater Rosa Benedict human respiration chamber. This equipment consists of an airtight copper chamber insulated by wooden valve with air phase in between. A folding bed, chair and table are provided in the chamber. A man can comfortably stay in the calorimeter for few days and do some work such as writing and reading. A small opening is provided as two ends for passing food and drinks and removing excreta. This chamber is ventilated by a current of air, carbon dioxide and water given off, and are removed by soda lime and sulfuric acid respectively. Oxygen utilized by the subject is replaced by introducing a known amount of oxygen through gas meter into chamber with air current. From the above, the quantity of oxygen consumed, carbon dioxide produced can be calculated. The heat produced is measured accurately by circulating a current of water through copper pipes and measuring the quantity of water entering and leaving the chamber. For example, the weight of an adult man is 65 kilogram. Amount of heat output in 24 hours is 2400 kilocalorie. Amount of oxygen consumed in 24 hours is 500 liters. The heat output per liter of oxygen consumed is 4.8 kilocalorie. From this calculation, it is easy to calculate energy output. This module is designed to know about the definition, different forms of energy, and what is the meaning of actual energy content of value and physiological fuel value of food. Apart from that one, we are able to understand the procedure involved to find out the actual energy content and also the physiological fuel value of food. Here, we are having some of the methods available to find out the actual content of energy and physiological fuel value of food. Students, by this time you all are aware of this aspect in an effective manner.